up himself down. Freiburg has the kill onto Maniac, and it's only Happy that stands between us and a third map, but he isn't standing anymore. 60-6 the map for Ninjas in Pyjamas. Inferno, but a distant memory. And we will move on to Cobblestone. And that was the moment that took us to where we are right now. Cobblestone stands between both the Ninjas in Pyjamas and Team LDLC from Fnatic in the grand final. And the shot at the first place prize, which is $100,000. $250,000 in total here to be won. Steel, thank you so much for your work thus far. But I must ask one more map of you.
Thanks for inviting me. And I love how in the NIP reaction video there, I hear your voice in the background, and I look over at you. You look so smug. You're like, yeah, that's my voice.
Well, who would be British if not to be smug? You know, that's what we, that's the one thing we've got.
This is true. I lived in England for a bit, so I know all about it.
You lived just up the road from me.
I did live up there, and we never got a beer.
We never did. You're a horrible... No, okay. Cobblestone. It's certainly one that we know that these two teams are familiar with these two teams on. How does that play into this?
It's going to play a lot into it. We might see something like, okay, when you see two teams playing a new map, you don't know necessarily what the other team's going to do, and you kind of play your own style, and then one team usually dominates another. It's not always generally going to be close, but these teams have practiced the map against each other over the course of the last few weeks. NIP, we've seen actually play it as recent as last night against Cloud9 in the third decider map against Cloud9, in which they won. But I mean, does that mean that LDLC has an edge over NIP? LDLC actually has a replay to watch of NIP. They had 5 minutes here. They could have just watched a pistol round. They could have watched a generic CT setup that NIP does. But I mean, it's just, I mean, LDLC also starts on the CT side. They have the higher seed.
So from that, as we jump into the map, I have to ask you to place your bets. Are you holding firm with NIP?
Oh, that's going to be close. Honestly, it could be either way. It could be a coin flip. I'm just going to say it's going overtime.
Looking for us. You guys won this on Prac, right?
Online.
So players to watch out for who have had great maps. Apex. Hot on both Inferno and Nuke. For the Ninjas, it was Inferno for Freiburg and Exist. Because quickly the action commences as out and towards the B main will be the Ninjas, but it's Apex flanking that you need to be aware of. Look at the top of your screen, that blue dot getting closer and closer as quickly those NIP players find themselves being picked off one by one, and a team kill goes into Fifth Laren as well. Get Right going to come through, chasing down Apex. Can he get him? Oh no! Kaylee will go down on the other side. Exist has got that, but it's 3 versus 1 and Exist will get no further. LDLC, strike first blood.
That was a great start from LDLC. Apex actually rushed all the way through A long hauls. As soon as he saw that there was not a single NIP player in that middle area, he flanked all the way through connector, full speed. The NIP players are pushing out into the B site. The LDLC members were calling for it. Apex, come, flank, flank, flank. Apex got a perfect flank off. The NIP members were just crushed from three different angles.
See Apex in that position again. How regularly will we see him do that today? As LDLC get himself the frag courtesy of Happy. Forrest, though, charges in. Downs in the end as he went to go looking for the weapon as well, but that will still be there as LDLC do get kills, but so do NIP. It's Exist 1-on-2. Has a Famous that he's picked up as well. And let's see whether LDLC can sandwich him. He's got all the work to do here. Without the bomb as well. As he retreats with some 60 seconds to go, his goal here is to just find that first frag, because then it's game on. Maniac will be the first person, and it is game on. Gets himself a big hit, and he will drop down looking for Apex, who at the same time has eyes on the bomb and has always left his eyes trained on that bomb.
Exist narrowly. He did spot him, though.
Oh, Exist gets... what a hit!
That's a great 1 versus 2 coming in from Exist. Using the full 60 seconds on the clock, moved his way over to the drop zone, was able to pick off Maniac in that Flowers area had the one versus one against Apex, and instead of like just walking out into an area, he was jumping over, spotting above the square, and saw that Apex was in the bomb site, took that 1v1 aim duel, and got the better of Apex. Huge round coming in from Nip.
Despite picking up that pistol round, what is it worth if you throw away the next and are forced onto a CZ round? Going up against Famous P90 and three AKs and an arsenal of grenades.
Slow start to this round. LDLC playing a very passive setup, and NIP not running into any traps, using the full round time to their advantage.
Fifth Laren here, after just two rounds, quickly realized that Apex, on the pistol round, will push all the way down, and on the second round, still pushed in and was able to then retreat back to round B, simply just holding back and saying, well, I'll just scout out, I'll just stay back, make sure that there are no surprises. Quick learning from NIP. Here we go with Apex getting bested by Get Right.
Happy just camping by the pooper and maybe trying to get a kill, maybe stop a bomb plant. But at this point, I mean, Nip has great positioning to get the bomb plant and to lock down the bomb from afar. They have control of the broken wall. They have control of drop zone, the E-box.
And with it, a two-man advantage, which quickly becomes a four-man advantage. Only Uzi left standing, does have himself a kill onto Get Right. But will go no further than that as they will hunt him down and drop him courtesy of Exist. 2-1 ninjas in pajamas.
Now, I can't say I agree with LDLC's setup there. They bought CZs in armor, but they played one in the back of B site, just isolated. Two people in A and two people in like B by connector. They're so split up. This is a long range map. Anybody who has a rifle should be winning these battles. And if you're playing these long range areas, you're not going to be able to do anything. They were too separated from one another. They couldn't establish crossfires. They couldn't get up close and personal with CZs. And they just lost a heavy investment. And that's something that they can't afford to do on the CT side of Cobble. This is a map that you want to have ops on. This is the map you want to have sniper rifles on. But we can see that... Is that Maniac is just hanging out somewhere.
No hands on the mouse.
Oh, he's just looking at his teammate's monitors to find out what's actually going on. So he's looking at his teammate, I believe, who's that over at the far right? That's Kaylee, right?
And here we go, action coming in as Get Right will see first action, and he'll be Apex who retreats away. And as he pulls back, now Maniac's ready to pick up that mouse and get involved.
So Kaylee at that point was the point man. He was at connector. He was spotting for middle. He was spotting for B. He was listening for drop all at the same time. So Maniac, just hiding in the A bomb site, was just like, I'm just going to look at your screen and find out what information is going on. Because sometimes, you know, it's better to look and see what's going on as opposed to, you know, hearing the communication from your team.
Come back to you on that. Interesting point as Get Right gets that next frag of the... LDLC players will have to contend with the fully armed and dangerous NIP assault. Happy got one, and Get Right goes down. And back to what we saw then. Something common on IY Power as well. How do you guys handle those types of scenarios? Do you look across your teammate's screen, or what do you...
Yeah, from time to time. It depends on the position you're playing. For example, if I'm playing and my teammate who's sitting next to me is... My mistake. That's a bit brutal. If I'm playing and I'm looking over to my left shoulder or my right shoulder and I have a teammate who's playing a sight with me, if I'm holding a flash out waiting for them to make contact with with an enemy, I'm going to be looking at their screen instead of letting them make contact and whatever, because I could hear a gunfire, but it could be them just spamming, it could be an enemy spamming. They might not necessarily have big contact, so I'll just go by whatever I see on the screen.
First hit coming in from... LDLC as they dispatch of Get Right. Fifth Laren down to 56, has lost 56 points of health as well, and this would be LDLC's way back. Having won the pistol, they then lost that crucial 2-on-1 courtesy of Exist that has followed up with two rounds lost thereafter. But they have the opening two frags this round. As Forrest will move in, pokes his head around the corner and does some damage. Can he follow this one up, or will that drawing the firing squad? That's exactly what it does, but Exist has the kill onto Maniac. Forrest then follows up with the return onto Apex. Still going is Forrest, but alone! And he is sent beyond. It becomes 2-3, LDLC back on the board.
We're actually going to see the op buy here from Kaylee, so this is the first op we're going to see from LDLC this half. Maybe he should just concentrate on his screen, unlike me.
And now, as we go into round six, the pressure starts to become a part of this. How much does the NIP experience play into moments like this, of which they've had plentiful?
I mean, it's gonna come into play a lot, but it's just NIP playing their game. They've always come back from deficits. We were talking last map about, or sorry, two maps ago when they've done 14-1 comebacks. So it's just gonna come down to just composure, keeping their calm, getting as many rounds on this T side as possible, and not throwing away too many opportunities, as we see Apex actually aggressive position again, just like he was doing on Nuke, getting that aggressive kill, making it a 5 versus 4, and making it that much easier for his teammates to lock down their spots on the site.
Apex has been just, you know, there's a saying coined by Rude Hullet of sexy football. Well, Apex is sexy Counter-Strike. He has pushed out time and time again, backs himself to deliver the frag, and does so happy this time. Reminding us of his brilliance as he gets himself a kill. Forrest goes down, courtesy of that man again. Kaylee will come in with a kill on to Exist, and now it is all on Getright, who has a 1 versus 5 to contend with. Getright will find himself between all of the LDLC players, maybe able to catch Maniac or Rusi, but he does exactly that. It's the first man goes down, Maniac without sight of it, but Getright will go no further, and we're tied back up at 3-3. What is a happy score for you on this one for either side? Who wants what?
LDLC would definitely want to look. I mean, they got the pistol round, they won the...
LDLC won the pistol, but then lost the following
three. E-code. So at this point in time, if they can maximize it, maybe get in 10 rounds, they could be happy going into the second half. That's the goal right now. Pick up 7 of these last 10 rounds. 10? 6? 9. 9 rounds. 7 of the last 9 rounds.
Here we go. It's Uzi who will nade in, put it right at the toes of the incoming Swedes as he gets himself the first on to Exist. It will be Uzi now to go back looking for more. They're all there for the taking on the other side of that smoke. Happy is also going to see action as Apex joins in the fragging. And this will be a conversion here. None of those CZs able to connect like they were in round 2. And LDLC are back in the lead.
Now 6 of the last 8 rounds. Hashtag math.
Obviously the Fnatic side will be eyes glued to this one. Always the advantage of going first.
And actually we see an op on Forrest here, and I wouldn't be surprised to see if he's actually looking for Apex to push aggressively either through the A-halls or into the window room, as he's done it before, but it looks like actually he's gonna opt to go somewhere not there.
Nade pinged in by Uzi. Not a great deal of damage done, only Fifth Iron losing 7 points of health. On the other side it is Uzi who's taken a few hits, but talk to us about this setup. You've got the two men poking in either direction with a bomb carrier latched in the middle. No commitment from the NIP side yet to either site.
It's often good to actually take middle control and push back A-halls, make the LDLC players play back in the site. That way you're able to do your fake strats, that way you're able to just do a fully commit on A, and it allows you to do splits from drop zone because all of the A and connector players are... Ooh, that's a great pick off by Kaylee.
Kaylee with the hit onto Freiburg and then the quick retreat as Happy comes in on the other side. It's Get Right that goes down. Kaylee might see action again, and he did. Forrest is the one who's gone, and now it's Fifflaren down by Apex. And this could be a clean sweep for them, as Exist will be the last man to come. And Kaylee knows he's there. Exist is going to go no further. A hat-trick for Kaylee. A great round with that AWP.
Great round for Kaylee. And as I was saying, just taking control of that area would be great for NiP. But, I mean, they walked around the corners. They didn't do anything together. And Kaylee was able to just pick them off and fall back into a passive position and get more pickoffs. So, I mean, LDLC is playing this absolutely perfectly. NIP is actually going to be on an eco here. And LDLC, to have a happy half, five more rounds.
On that NIP side, the scoreboard, not pleasant reading for Freiburg or Fifflaren. Some eight rounds into the game, only one frag between the two of them. We are on board with Freiburg. Grenade goes off above the two of them. They're on a CC round. We've seen them taking one of these before.
Shit, it looks like they're going to sneak the bomb towards A with this V pressure.
Here will come the bomb movement. Exist gets himself the first onto Maniac, followed up by Apex and Kaylee coming in with two of their own. Freiburg returns the favor, and we're tied up at three people left alive on either side. Get Right, though, not happy with that, gets himself one more. Again, the trade. Apex returns onto Exist, and he has himself eyes on the prize. But picking up that bomb will be Freiburg, who has a one versus two. This is what Exist did as well in that second round. Can they follow up as Freiburg puts in the code and then gets dropped by Apex? Bomb planted and three frags on a CZ round. Not too shabby for the Ninjas, but the scoreline will be 6-3.
Actually, Freiburg had an incendiary on his back there. He picked it up, and actually he wasn't afraid to push into the incendiary that Apex threw on the bomb. Freiburg ran straight at it because it had just basically just started setting it on fire. He just ran in, got the bomb, ran to the bomb site, got that bomb plant money. That's $800 per player, plus an extra $300 to Freiburg. That's $4,300 right there. That's a great, great play from Freiburg, just getting that bomb plant, securing it. But maybe it would have been interesting to see if he had thrown that incendiary grenade just before he started the bomb plant.
To the fire goes Forrest as Happy helps himself to one. So close to the second, but Uzi will help him out with it as he does again. Fifflaren is down. Freiburg now putting up a resistance, but not for long. It's only Get Right and 22 points of health against four fully armed Frenchmen who get themselves the next round. 10 rounds in, it is 7-3. And we are due for a pause. Looking across the screens, it seems to be a calm down pause, or...
I don't know. I'm just looking at LDLC over there, and they're just like, they're waving their arms around. I see them shouting something. I don't know what they're shouting at or about, but it looks like they're actually quite happy.
Yeah, I'm wondering if the cameraman can throw us over to the on-stage picture. So that's NIP.
They're having a chat for sure. They're talking about something. I don't think they have any technical difficulties. I just think they're taking a time out to find out what's going on.
But no, it looks like Uzi talking to Messioso. Some problem for LDLC. Maybe NIP just had something really interesting on the floor.
We saw this happen in the last game as well, or was it Inferno? But there was a pause that happened. We didn't exactly know who called the pause, but it was good in the sense that it broke the momentum. LDLC had a great lead, and it broke their momentum having that pause. So, I mean, NIP can take advantage of this moment right here.
There is something on that floor.
Maybe it's a broken bottle.
I'm going to guess it's Peter down there.
Oh, could be.
Maybe offering some form. I wonder if the cameraman can get over and around the back of them.
And then under the table, and then...
Yeah. What is down there, Mr. Cameraman?
Who is under the table? And what is... are they doing there?
It was Peter.
Was it Peter?
And he must have had a laptop or a playbook or something just saying, this is how you gotta root it out. And that's where we're at right now in Counter-Strike. The role of the coach is a fascinating one. And say hello to the crowd once again.
Press Fifflaren.
We have ourselves a third map. That's what all the neutrals wanted. It's LDLC with a minor advantage at 7-3 up, but on that CT side. Thank you for joining us. I understand there's a big line around the corner as well to get into this hall. Counter-Strike's back where it belongs here in the ESL in Germany. And on the main stage once more with $250,000 to go. The final still to come as well. Fnatic waiting in it. Who will join them? There's the motivational talk. Is of absolutely no harm to take this time to make sure that these players are fully psyched up, fully prepared for what's to come.
I think Apex is on fire right now. I mean, he's feeling it. He's confident. He's... You don't even see him, like, he's not depressed. He's not upset. He is in top form. You can see it in-game. You can see it on his face. He's composed. Net players are...
Net players rarely show anything other than this, though.
Yeah, but, like, even on Nuke, like, they were getting excited. At the end of Inferno, they were getting excited. But here, they're not excited. They don't have the same excitement that they had in the last games. But Apex here, he looks mean. He looks ready. He looks focused. And he looks like he's nervous because he's biting his nail. What a bad habit.
So here we go. Happy is the...
Happy is happy?
He's basically got that Pharrell Williams song just playing in the background 24-7. 7-3, welcome back. Interesting, in rounds 1 and 2, Apex extended a lot more into this area. Let's see whether he can do it again. It's been quiet at the extension, but it's Fifflaren that he will chase, and he's got the AWP helping him. He's desperate for some information, and in the end, it cost him his life.
Definitely an overextension in that point. Going up that far, I mean, he poked his head out where he was exposed from the connector as well. He should have just taken a step or two back, and he would have been in prime location to catch someone off guard, if not two players. But he was definitely playing off his AWPer, Caitlyn, who was pushed up in the A hulls, trying to take the attention off the player from NiP, who's, I don't even know what to call that middle statue area. Let's call it middle statue.
What we're left with, though, is a very fragmented defense. Two on B, two very far away on A. Let's see whether LDLC can make something work for them as the Swedes come charging at them. First frag will go the way of Forrest as he opens up that B site. It will now have to all come to Happy and Kaylee to deal with something. They still have the men, but they're running out fast. And Steel, you are shaking your head.
That was poor play right there from Happy. He should have stayed in that god spot on the top of the stairs, shooting the feet of the NIP players as they're pushing to the site. Instead, he ran down the stairs, exposed himself, and he got taken out. He was in prime position to make a huge play there, and he just threw away that all, just everything. He could have turned that around.
A round of two individual mistakes?
I'm disappointed with that. Apex overextended, Happy overextended. Uzi was just left there fighting by himself by the square. He didn't have any support from his team. Kaylee missed a shot from the connector onto the B bomb site when the NiP players were crossing. Just, I mean, a lackluster round from LDLC. And you know what? It happens. When you're playing on fire so much, you expect to hit your shots and just make big plays. But sometimes you just have to relax and sit back and be confident. But we are going to see Kaylee
bringing out the orb. They got plenty of money across that team regardless.
He's got a nice 13K in the bank, so he could buy up for the next few rounds. He could opt. Even if they lose the next three rounds in a row, he can opt every single one of them.
And what's bad rounds happened. So, NIP, 7-4, down to an LDLC side who have been one of the bright sparks of this tournament. Came in good form. And are well worth their semi-final spot. See whether they can get to the grand final. They're 9 rounds away from it. And you wonder who Fnatic would rather play. Would they rather play LDLC or would they rather play NIP? It's a question of the known in NIP. Versus perhaps the, well, less frequently played. I'm not going to call them unknown, that's for sure. That Swedish rivalry has been bested in the DreamHack final, of course. NIP setting themselves up for a push in towards the B. Can Uzi and Happy make amends this time around. They lead the charge, and it'll be Exist again who gets the first. Now Uzi in a position Happy was in last round, and they lose man after man, and Steel is shaking his head to my left. Kaylee with the AWP from afar, trying to pick someone off, but as he's flashed, he's been taken out of the equation, and a 2-on-5 after Blunt isn't going to happen. And that will be two very big rounds for NIP, and both with that, both courtesy of that clean B entry, which has upset you again.
Yeah, I mean, LDLC, they had the, I mean, when Kaylee was going there for the kills, they have the economy to work with. They can definitely go for it. But, I mean, there's smokes and flashes coming from NIP, and the response from LDLC was non-existent. It just, there was no response. There was no smokes or flashes into the choke points. NIP members were able, is Apex going to live? Apex will live. He'll be able to hold on to his gun. There was no response from LDLC. They didn't counter smoke. They didn't counter flash. When they peeked out one by one. One by the broken wall, he dies. Then Uzi's by the square, he dies. There's no like actual support. There's no crossfire. There's no one person flash and the other guy peek. There's no smoke at the choke points. And then they just fell apart. They just collapsed. And NIP was able to secure themselves another round.
And since the break, NIP have picked up two in a row.
Yeah, and LDLC, as I was saying earlier, they want to end this half with 10 rounds. They still have the economy to do so, but they really need to start locking down that B site. That's how they've been losing a couple of the rounds.
It's Kaylee who may just get a glimpse of Exist. And for the first round in three, they will get the opening frag. He will retreat. And NIP will regather.
I like what Kaylee's doing in this position right now. He got the aggressive pick. He got the pick off, made it a 5-on-4, and moved around.
Oh, almost on to fifth flower, and he's down to 13 points of health. And continue.
But, yeah, you can see he's just never in the same spot twice. He makes his presence one spot with his AWP, and then instantly shifts around and moves somewhere else. And this keeps NIP guessing. They take angles slower, they have to jiggle peek, they have to make sure that there's no AWPer holding that angle, they have to waste flashes and smokes and time. And we're gonna see GetRight actually getting another kill here, so this is a 4-on-4.
And frags galore as Forrest and Freiburg get one for the NIP side. Kaylee was there to avenge, as Forrest will now charge over towards that A site and put that bomb down, has support to his right and left, and an incoming Uzi and Happy who will make their entrance almost hand in hand as they offer two opportunities. They know that Fifth Laren's low on health. Who Kaylee knew he hit that shot. But that's all they've got to work with. Still nades on that side as well, and frags as well. Freiburg close it out. And NIP have won now three in a row, and what was a truly textbook CT half for LDLC, where they were on course for, as you said, 10, has suddenly not gone to plan, and a timeout is called. Credit to them, I suppose, for not allowing the rot to set in. Mm-hmm.
But again, they have the economy. They've had the economy the whole way through their counter-terror side to keep buying, to keep buying. They had the entry kill. They had the 5-on-4 advantage. They dropped the Flarin to lower health with that leg shot, but then they lost the round late round. How did they lose it? They lost it in drop zone. They gave away a kill to get right. You don't need to take those peaks. You don't need to take those angles. Wait for the terrorists to come out through the choke points when they're at disadvantages. You already have the man advantage, so all they have to do is lock down the choke points at the time. Apex and Kaylee are doing a great job of getting these opening picks. Once they have one pick, they should just fall back. They should just play passive. They should just use that man advantage. Play the AWP more. You could still peek with long range with the AWP, but you play more defensively. Maybe lock down the drop zone. That's where NIP likes to go a lot. They've been going to the drop zone a lot as soon as there's a reaction. Every time NIP goes A, they have someone coming through the drop zone. Every time NIP goes B, they have someone coming through the drop zone. They need to lock that down. They need to lock down with two people watching the B choke point, and Kaylee is just roaming around A, and he's doing a great job of that. So,
and how much was that a point called out on by Peter in that last timeout? Because he's the one who was like, right, guys, you got to change something up. He was the one who offered the change for NIP to stop their rot and inflict this.
Well, honestly, I think that was more of a misplay in the last three rounds that NIP picked up. That was more of a misplay by LDLC than it was a proper play from Nip, because like Nip went out, it was like a classic B take, but there was no defense coming in from LDLC.
So we are delicately poised.
And you know what, Nip right here, they're just warming up their hands, they're just hanging out, they're waiting for this pause to end. It doesn't even look like they're chatting about anything. They're just confident with their game. I think they're just going to keep doing what's been working for them right now, and they're not going to change anything up. But here we see LDLC, they want to pick up these last two rounds in the half. They know how important these are. They'd rather use their timeout now than use it in the second half. And you know what, it makes sense. If they pick up these last two rounds, it's going to make the second half that much more easy.
Where's your money now, as we are a third of the way through?
Nip's looking really strong at this point. Picking up, what is it, six rounds already that they have? Six rounds on the Terra side. This is a great start. I mean, this is more than you can ask for on Cobble T side. So Nip's looking really strong individually, as a team, everything.
Let's see whether that pause had anything to offer. Kaylee had a shot there and wasn't able to hit what was never an easy shot. Shots coming through the smoke from Freiburg, and he's heavily tagged back up. And indeed, Forrest has been down to 38 points of health. So between them, they've done a lot of damage to this side before they can even get to see an LDLC player. Makes the job all the more easier when they do. Get Right's played an excellent roaming role in this game. 12 frags in these rounds, but each one of them has just been an annoying frag for LDLC, one that they didn't want to lose in a position they didn't want to lose them, as he continues to be the rotator. I'm sure we should make rotator sound more intimidating when it's referring to Get Right. Apex and Apex again with two frags. Get Right going down. Kaylee will then get himself the next and the next, and that's more like it. LDLC, they have just a fifth Laren to finish off, and he is downed by Apex's hat trick frag. And between the two of them, they got all five frags. It is 8-6, and the possibility is either 8-7 or 9-6. Tough times for LDLC. They know that this is their moment. They know that their CT side is really not that bad. A few individual errors, a few missed opportunities, and that's what wins games. Wins or loses games.
And Kaylee actually, he went for that aggressive pick last round. He just narrowly missed it, but that's the right idea. That's the kind of play that they need to make if they want to kind of turn the tides in their favor. You don't want to overextend too much, as we see Nip is actually preparing for that. They don't want to give anything away. Actually, Fifflarn's going to smoke him off perfectly. Forrest is in the tower as well, looking for that Kaylee aggressive play.
And that's a sign of how much they fear the dominance of Kaylee thus far with that AWP. On board with him once again, as he sits back. It's Freiburg who has the bomb and retreats. He will line up for the attack now. And NIP are about to make their push. Here we go. Last man gets into position. Uzi loses a bit of health, and the nades come flying on in. And it will be the assault now from the ninjas, as the nades are returned. And I think it was a Molotov tossed over there, just held back NIP from coming in. They're going to charge in once more, and it'll be Exist and Forrest who go through. Uzi was waiting for them, but NIP, as they have done so many times going into B, have got the better of them and will now be left with Maniac 1-on-4. He gets the first, he gets the second, but can go no further. Get Right makes sure of that. And NIP go into halftime just one round down. And they want to set up the revenge final against Fnatic.
That's an amazing start to the half, to the game for NIP. If they go into the CT side, I mean, they're going in full confidence. If they win this pistol, it's just, that's all she wrote. There's no bouncing back from LDLC if LDLC loses this pistol.
That is not the spirit of the Shoutcaster, Josh. The spirit is that anything is possible. The magic can happen.
The spirit of the analysis is that they need this pistol. It's as simple as that. Facts are facts, bro.
Absolutely. get right with his Swedish flag behind him.
I thought we're not allowed anything on the back of the chair.
Ooh. Disqualified. Disqualified.
Exist has had a big game.
Yeah, he's been playing well. We've seen moments from all of the NIMP players there. I mean, NIMP's really come together as a team. They are not the same team that we saw in the first map of the series.
How much can it just be affected by getting warmed up?
A lot. I mean, we saw they were missing all their shots in Inferno. Once you play that first game, get that out of the way, I mean, oftentimes that's when the team's able to warm up. I mean,
how much do you prefer scenarios where you get kind of a group game out of the way, you stay on the same PCs, you get warmed up, you play through like 3-4 games in a day?
I love that. I hate when you play and then rest and then play and then rest. I mean, you lose so much of your momentum. You're basically building yourself, charging yourself up, getting really energetic, and then you play and you're putting all your energy in and you want to just keep going. You want to keep going. If you just stop, then you lose all of that momentum, you lose all of that energy, you get drained, you get tired, and then you have to build it up from the bottom again. And each time you take a break, whether it be a day, whether it be a few hours, I mean, that's just killing so much of your momentum. You're not as warm, you're not as prepared, you're not as confident, and you don't play as well. It's as simple as that.
So here we go. LDLC with the slenderest of advantages going into the second half of map 3. And Steele has said, it's all or nothing on this pistol round, which they did win last time around on the CT side, only to then be echoed out the following. It's Happy that's advanced the furthest. He may be able to catch Fifflaren out as Fifflaren retreats, but reinforcements will go around to him, and Fifflaren has to retreat all the way back in towards that site. Forest being pushed out as well, and the hay push is alive and well as Fifflaren has the first frag. Big one. Kaylee goes down, and Forest is going to fire across towards him as well. LDLC trying to use that bomb site for cover, but Fifflaren going down, fighting, gets himself his second. Maniac and Apex return the favors, though, as Forest, though, dealing exclusively in headshots, gets himself one more. 2-on-2. Get right with just 7 points of health, but you wouldn't know it, as Freiburg has himself the kill onto Maniac, and Apex has 2, will need 4 to win this half 4, or to win this round 4. LDLC gets the first. Can he get the second? Freiburg versus Apex. Freiburg wins! And NIP tie up the game.
If Apex won that in that 1-2, that would have been a huge momentum boost for the LDLC team. They would have been propelled right into the second half, getting these next 2 rounds probably. But NIP, I mean, Freiburg picking up that round there, that's going to be huge for NIP. It's going to really turn the tides of the battle.
LDLC now need to dig deep. They are under the gun from the most consistently successful side in CSGO history, who have finished outside of the top 4, but only a handful of times, and who are looking to prove their doubters wrong after Gfinity. They deliver when it matters, and they want their vengeance on Fnatic.
Another slow start to the round. NIP's not taking any chances. Looks like LDLC is just copying a feel as well.
Like it. First shots fired in anger as Apex begins to make the move towards A. Fifflaren is waiting for him, and Fifflaren is not going to get the better of him. Apex is a man possessed right now. But on the other side, Uzi has been down. Remember, this is Eco from LDLC, who will have Gatright and his P90 to contend with in just a second, as he finds Happy and downs Happy. Freiburg with the next, gets it. Kaylee downed, and NIP now just one away from closing this.
In these situations, I mean, LDLC is buying CZs and they're buying P250s, but they're splitting up so widespread. It looks like they're not even trying to win the round, but just try to inflict as much damage as possible. Maybe pick up a few frags and just chip away at NIP's economy, but Apex really needs to just push out and die at this point in time. If you let the clock run out and then you die after the timer, you get $0 going into the next round. So Apex really needed to push out and die in that situation. That's why he just basically made that play.
Ninjas in Pajamas have the lead for the first time since they were 3-1 up. Now, LDLC have a mountain building against them. Momentum very much lost after that timeout in the first half. And NIP's dominance has continued in towards this second half. Do they have something for the old masters, the young upstarts?
They have a rifle buy. That's a start.
Let's see how they use it.
Looks exactly like their Inferno play. Just slow, methodical, clear out all the angles. And then they're going to group up and make a play.
But Inferno is a thinner map. And the speed to get across from one side to the other is a lot quicker as Apex gets himself the kill onto Fifth Laren. Fifth Laren mixing up where he was in A for the second round in a row, but not able to get past Apex for the second round in a row. And oh, what a hit from Kaylee gets Freiburg, and that will force a retreat coming in from Exist, who will be down, and it's headshots galore for LDLC. In the end, Maniac is going to get right, and that leaves 1-on-5 for Forest, and a very clean round for LDLC. They needed something big, and they got it.
That's actually a good indication that they still have their heads in the game, and they actually could bring this to a very close score line. I mean, I was talking so much about how if NIP's able to just maximize the rounds and get on the CT side and win the pistol, they're probably going to lock down this game, but LDLC is showing a lot of composure on that round, and they're probably going to pick up this next round. I mean, it is a force buy from NIP, but if LDLC takes the same approach into this following round, and if Kaylee's able to hit those shots and Apex is able to make his plays, they're going to be looking very strong into the second half. It might be a much closer game than I initially thought.
On board with Fifth Laren, who will soon have Kaylee showing, and the flash just allows Kaylee to push in and push Fifth Laren back, who you don't envy in that position. Katrina Zelica still believes in LDLC. Tweet into hashtag ESL1 to share your thoughts. And remember, all items, the stickers and the game are on sale this week on Steam. So show your support. Fifth Laren will get, Maniac, but not to be. Maniac down to 10 points of health as now Forrest will see action and see it in some style. 1, 2, nice work from Forrest. Down to Bomb Carrier as well as the crowd applaud. And the complexity of this round has been changed out once more. Can Forrest make it 3? You bet he can. Finally, Happy has had enough. Kaylee helps him out as well, and they will reclaim the bomb with it. We're in a 2-on-2, Exist and Freiburg versus Happy and a very heavily wounded Kaylee. Can Exist do the job? No, but he's done the damage. As the bomb will go down, and Happy is 1-on-2. 1-on-1, Exist is out for the count. Freiburg, can he do what he did in the pistol and win the round in the 1v1? Happy shows himself, and Happy almost goes down. Freiburg finishes off with aplomb, and that will be that. Cometh the hour, cometh Freiburg. How many times has he done that? And look at the faces in the bottom left of your screen. The disappointment is there for all to see. Would you have played that 1-on-1 different? Use the clock a little bit more, play a little more ring around the rosies?
I think the way he played it was all right. Maybe take an extra second to delay in between peaks. I mean, the peaks that you do, you want to take pop shots, but you want to be unpredictable. If you just peek, hide, and then re-peek immediately, then, Freiburg's just going to be aimed at you still. So, I mean, the bomb was just planted. It's so difficult to actually play the full duration of the timer when your opponent's that close to you. So I think the way he played it was fine. He just got a nice shot onto the other player just beforehand, so
may have been just a millisecond away from the frag himself. Forest versus Apex. as Apex wins the battle. Fifth Laren had reinforcements that time up on Long A, but wasn't to be for him. And now Apex, he's just a one-man army at the moment. Causes a massive distraction. Getright has had to move. And he is the dividing force as he goes looking for Getright. Smokes one side, and Freiburg is wondering whether it's to which side that attack is coming. As he finds the frag on towards Happy, the bomb is now going to move the other way around. And here comes Maniac. He'll see Getright first, will he? As Apex has moved around, also looking for him. And LDLC, despite having that two-frag advantage, weren't able to really race the bomb into either site thereafter, despite the confusion on the NIP side. Freiburg's going to be next, spotted by Apex. Apex will want Avenge for the last one, but Freiburg will get it. Maniac comes in and downs Freiburg in the end. Still the one man up for LDLC, as they have got that bomb in place now. First frag from Kaylee. Zist knows that this is not one he can win, and he gets out of there to hold on to that weapon. But they'll tie us back up. It will be 10-10.
This is huge individual play coming out from LDLC. We saw Apex just running in through upper. He didn't even run in like all the way. He just slowly, methodically cleared all the angles. He cleared the close angle, got the kill, did a nice 90 degree flick, got the other kill. Once he got those two kills, he knows that the site is, you know, 90% of the time, it's going to be clear. He just ran straight into the site, kept control of it, waited for his teammates to come back and get the bomb planted. So great individual performance from Apex, securing that bomb site. And that's the individual play that they're going to need if they want to close out this game.
His play on Long A, like, they moved Forrest over there to help Fifth Laren that last round. But even still, he got through. He is a tank. This time, Forrest pushed all the way up and will meet him much closer to home.
Pretty sure Apex is going to clear this.
Oh, the commentator's curse strikes as Forrest strikes to get himself the kill. And we'll retreat back. And they've taken out one of the big threats. But a mixed buy from that NIP side. And the thing is, for the past few rounds when LDLC have done well, it's all come from Apex. So someone else now is going to have to show up.
Well, Kaylee's still alive. He still has his AWP, and he's actually leading in. So this might be the opportunity that they need.
Gets himself the kill onto Freiburg. Exist is going to be the next in the firing line as Kaylee comes around the corner. Gets dropped by Exist, but Uzi comes in and returns. Forrest now looking for his second frag. Will he get it? Almost. As he will then be hounded down, surely. No! How did Maniac not finish that one off? But still, Forrest downed in the end. As the first frag comes in from Getright. And it is Happy versus Getright. 20 points of health versus 100. And Happy has to go and get that bomb as well. And he knows where it is, and he knows where Happy is. And Getright has the perfect position to do something about it. But in the end, Happy gets there. As the flash comes in, Happy goes in towards that bomb site. He has to have hurt Getright, and he delivers for LDLC. Huge play from Happy. Getright with the health advantage and knowing everything that Happy was doing, was still unable to stop him.
I'm stunned. That round turned around so many times. LDLC had the advantage. Forrest made a huge play. Nip got the advantage. Getright had the positioning and the health advantage. Nip had the advantage. Happy came out with the clutch. There's nothing to analyze. That was just great overall individual play from both teams.
11-10. LDLC back in the lead as the lead trades round for round. We are on the edge of our seats in this second semi-final. Uzi tanks Freiburg on 58, and it is a 3-CZ round here for the Ninjas, who are being pushed back by LDLC.
You can see the value, actually, $25,000 versus $1,300, which is basically 3 CZs.
Kaylee with frag number one. Kaylee with frag number one.
Kaylee.
Three different pronunciations of that.
Kaylee, Kaylee, Kaylee.
We get right ready to drop down and join in, but they were expecting it, and Maniac gets him. Now they have a two-man advantage with Getright and Forrest down. Freiburg will be the next, and then it will be Fifth Laren to fall down as well. And this will leave Just Exist last man up, and it will be a two-round cushion. And every round, the tension mounts just that little bit more. From here, how's your bet looking? You've backed the Ninjas.
I backed the Ninjas, but LDLC's T-side is very, very strong right now. And Nip just doesn't have the answer for it. I think if Nip were to do anything right now, it would be get Ops. Ops on Flarn, Ops on Forest. Forest goes for that mid pick, maybe kills Apex as he's charging to the upper A hulls. I mean, those are the decisions that they have to make at this point. We haven't been seeing any aggressive pickoffs with an op at all from Nip. And that's what they need to do at this point.
They focus their variation on dealing with Apex. And that has worked to a point in the last two rounds. And let's see whether they
buy an op for Flarn.
Take your advice.
And
they
Forest.
Do. It's like they're listening to you. Or it's like you're an expert color commentator calling what would happen.
Ah, you flatter me.
I'll take it back, though.
They're doing exactly what I said they should do. Oh, my God.
You know that having now called that, you put your neck on the line for this.
Apex is just going to one-shot both of them.
If it doesn't work, the whole of Sweden will hate you. Who will strike first? Apex. Worried about taking on Fifth Laren with the orb. Not sure they would have seen it just yet. Don't think Fifth Laren's fired a shot. He hasn't.
Still great positioning by the A players.
Now the two orbs are side by side.
Such an off angle by Forrest there. Great positioning for that entry kill. Forrest. Apex did not expect that.
And they're still not aware of the second AWP. It's Forrest that's fired two shots.
That's correct. And there's also a good setup going on here. If LDLC pushes into the B-bomb site, I don't know if they'll be able to take it. Freiburg's in Godspot, but we also have Exist lurking in the prowl.
Here we go, LDLC ready to make their push. Flash comes in, Maniac jumps out, and the LDLC side begin to take damage. They push in, it's Maniac that's gone the furthest, but he won't get anything, and it's only Kaylee who's got the kill for LDLC. They have but two players left standing, and Uzi is one of them, gets himself the first, and is then downed, and NIP will claim themselves the round. And Happy got away with his lives in the end, but 12-11.
Great setup there by Nip. I wouldn't be surprised if we see something similar or maybe even a tiny bit more aggression coming out of either Fifth Laren or Forest on
so
that. Just
now you have to earn your keep. How do you counter the strat that you just suggested? What do LDLC have to do to take on those two orbs today?
If they saw the double... I mean, one of the things they could do is if they are able to smoke and flash Forest off and push Fifth Laren back with rifles and then do what Nip did to them in Sansa, you do like three down drop zone, flank connector to A and two people push up A, that could work. I mean, B is just so heavily locked down by the rifles. You have the two oppers coming back to retake the site long range. I think A would be the best place to hit or connector. I mean, connector against ops is great.
Get Right gets the first frag. Happy goes down. Forrest and his AWP will not have seen those bodies jump across. And Apex has reinforcements, and they're all going to come straight into the AWP's line of territory. He's seen the first, doesn't connect, and Apex has the warning shot across his bow. And can he get anything? No. Forrest bests him this time, and for NIP there. Time is now. They have the upper hand in this one, which they follow up with Fifth Laren connecting, and the two AWPers are out in the open as Maniac is the next one. Maniac will get the frag on the Forest, but will get no further. Get Right avenges the death of his beloved, and now it will be Uzi to be the last man standing, and Get Right, I think, got three that round.
Nip's making the best adjustment possible. This is just so hard to counter. The way LDLC has been setting up and playing, Nip has the perfect counter into LDLC. LDLC has to entirely change their default style here. We see that they have to eco. Kaylee's got his head in his hands. It's a double facepalm. It's a double-handed facepalm. But look, every round.
Look at the bottom left of your screen. Look at the gesticulation. Look at the strats being called.
Yeah, and we see Maniac, he's just talking to his team, but he's still in spawn. And sometimes this is what you have to do. If you're on an eco round, you can use your eco round as a timeout. You still have like that minute and a half where you can just talk about what you're going to do in the next round. And your teammates can go and like put a little bit of pressure so you don't get pushed in by Nip completely. But you're just basically talking. What's happening? How are the enemies set up? How's Nip setting up at the moment? What can we do to combat it? And then when you figure out like a game plan for the following round, that's when you're just like, all right, let's get this round over with. And it looks like they're just going to group up and try to brute force their way through and try to get some kills.
At 12-12 in a semi-final in map 3, I wonder how calm that conversation really is. NIP have got the first two frags, and they will follow it up with the remaining. And they have the lead once again. They're three away from Fnatic, but the French side have not given up once in this match.
So here we're going to have to see what LDLC was just talking about in that round before. Maniac still talking to his team, I guess just reiterating the point, getting that point across. Either that, or he's just whining at his team, but I don't think he would be doing that right now. I think he's actually giving some productive insight into what they should do different.
Plan A for LDLC on this map has been go, go Apex. What is plan B?
Go, go Kaylee? Go, go Gadget Kaylee? Maybe go, go Gadget rest of the team? Or does that mean?
That is mean.
I
and
apologize.
You're not a mean man.
I'm not a mean man.
Despite what Lopez says about you.
Yeah, but...
12-13. And there is Apex getting the better of Fifth Laren this time for the first in a few rounds. And that has put the heebie-jeebies into this NIP side as now Forrest must deliver with the AWP and does so. Maniac can go no further, and every one of the NIP frags is being drawn on by this crowd. Who would have thought the German crowd would not want to see a French team in the final as Exist gets himself the next one onto Kaylee, and now it is Freiburg and Aiden Exist down. He only had 5 points of health, mind you, but Freiburg gives away his position as he tries to drop Uzi, and now they about turn and look for the big man, and he gets it. Big hit onto Uzi. Happy's the last man up now, and he will get no further. And NIP are two away from victory, and the crowd find their feet once more. And let's see what they've got to offer. This is going to be the last chance salute for LDLC.
The right idea by LDLC there as well, and you can see the emotions coming out of them, especially Kaylee at the end, closest to the camera. After they lost that round, gut-wrenching. Honestly, it just is. They had the right idea, they had the right tactics. Freiburg just in a great position to shut that down. Had LDLC got the kill on Freiburg, they're in. That was their round. You can see the force by here. They don't want to let it go to overtime. They don't want to let Nip get onto match point. But this is a do or die situation here. They need to win out from this point. And Nip's economy is just too strong at the moment. They're going to be able to rebuy every round.
This is what makes champions. Do LDLC have what it takes to overcome NIP in a stacked deck against them as they find themselves with the experience and the years and the raw talent of Ninjas in Pyjamas armed and dangerous against them? But LDLC have come this far and they've given up not once.
I wish some people could see your facial reactions when you're actually casting.
We can save them that horror. Getrag goes down, gets himself the... Oh, I was going to say gets himself the first frag, but no. Kaylee does get it back with the help of Uzi. And we're at 4-on-4. And here we go with Happy. And raw guns combine as Happy and Kaylee connect. And Freiburg and Exist are down. NIP suddenly having questions after them for the first time in a few rounds. Maniac gets himself the kill on DeForest, and Fifth Laren is the last man standing up against four. He'll go for it, he's got nothing to lose, but this will pull us back to a one-round game once more.
If Lauren's just hanging out here going for an exit kill, be interesting to see what the money situation is for NIP.
You just said they could buy out.
Yep. Definitely can buy out all the way. But if we look at LDLC's money, they can't afford to lose any players at all at this point. So Fiflarin, I mean, I don't see why he's not going for more exits. More like actually putting more pressure on the LDLC members. Maybe taking away that op. That'd be a good play for him in that situation.
One round, the difference. What did LDLC do right that round?
They ground out the round at B. They got the kills. They fought rifle versus rifle. They bypassed the ops entirely once they saw that Forest was up close and personal with Apex in middle. Well, it wasn't even up close. It was long range and personal. But once they identified that Forest was there, they just bypassed him completely, went toe-to-toe with rifles at the B-bomb site. And you know what? That might be what we see again coming up in this next round.
Kaylee's got his AWP back. Here he is. He's looking for Forest. It was actually Fiflarin who pushed down there a lot. They're still worried about that push. The push that silenced Apex down on Long A has taken the wind out of the LDLC sails. But they know that they themselves are just three away from the final.
And an extra $23,000.
Who's counting? Apex has advanced back into his favored area. He's now going to chase down onto... I was going to say he's going to go up to Fiflarin, but he didn't. Maniac has now pushed a long, long way. And here we go with NIP looking to flash out the incoming LDLC assault. It's Kaylee who strikes first. Get right down. Exist going to go around through the smoke looking for, I think it's Kaylee who's over there, but won't go any further as Kaylee stops him back. Freiburg can't connect. Kaylee with the hat trick. Kaylee dragging LDLC through this one. By the scruff of his neck, he does it. And LDLC have tied the game back up. It is 14 all.
Huge play coming in there from Kaylee. And that's exactly what they needed to do. Apex was putting pressure on A, just keeping the A players just occupied, just even for that, you know, few seconds that he was there for. But then LDLC smoked off the right. They walked out B, and they took those rifle battles. And Kaylee, I mean, Kaylee just making a quick 3K. He was going in head on with his AWP, point blank.
The 300,000 people watching this, we welcome you all. This is, well, this is sensational.
Actually, it was 310,000 people.
This is CS at its finest.
Danger, danger. So we're just waiting for LDLC to set up. They're probably going to end up doing the same tactic that they did the round before. It's been working out best for them. They want to push this to the 15th round, push it into overtime. NIP opting for a different setup this time, though.
Here we go with Freiburg, who... This time it'll be Get Right who gets the first frag. He gets the second, followed up with Exist, and this time NIP have started much better. Freiburg with frag number three. Apex and Happy have returned the favors, but still a man advantage, two-man advantage on the NIP side. Happy, the only man left alive. And he has 31 points of health to do something, and Exist waiting for him. And that will be the end of him. NIP are on match point.
Great reaction from NIP. I mean, LDLC kept pushing that B bomb site. They knew that they had that way in. After their A stuff stopped working because NIP reacted to it, they started going B. That stuff worked so well, just going B and fighting out the rounds. But then NIP, instead of playing that passive B setup, they played up close and personal. They had the players watching the B main entrance, watching the drop zone, and that really shut down LDLC. So LDLC, they need this round to push it overtime. It's just do or die right here, and it looks like they're going back to what they were initially doing.
Well, with the fear that they have of the AWPer and someone pushing out Long A, they've stopped Apex going down there. But the AWPer's gone and has been gone for three rounds. It may well be time to revert back to what worked so well for the first half of this T side.
It looks like we're actually going to see just that. Tossbot new analysis?
I wouldn't wish that on anyone.
modest.
Apex clearing out as he, in the early rounds, was just a magnet for Fifth Laren. He would find him in here and just drop him within seconds. And having cleared out, having no, there's no one there, they're going to switch up. What's the plan now? Happy looking for Freiburg. Freiburg showing nothing. This is Freiburg disciplined to the end, waiting for something to hit, and it'll be Exist and Get Right at Freiburg, and they're only one frag away from the final. It's Kaylee versus NIP. Can he deliver? No! Ninjas in Pajamas charge into the grand final of the Counter-Strike Global Offensive Challenge here at the ESL1 in Cologne. Phenomenal play from NIP. Coming back from one map down, they have rallied and they have launched themselves into the grand final where they will seek their vengeance on Fnatic. And there they celebrate. They have had to work so, so hard, and LDLC have been such great competitors, but have been downed in the end, and it will be an all Swedish final. Josh, your closing thoughts.
Great, great, just endurance by NIP there. They were down on the first map. They lost the first map in a huge style. LDLC really took the reins there, but then NIP brought it back on the map two and map three. Very well played. Shows that they never give up.
And look at those scenes, both joy and despair matched next to each other. Let's throw it over to the analysis desk. Sir Scoots, what do you think?
Thank you, Tosspot and Steel. We need to give Nathan a second or two to calm down.
Definitely.
We talked about the sixth man a lot this weekend. This match, you were basically the seventh man back here, losing your mind.
You know, I was obviously rooting for the Frenchies all the time, but I mean, NIP played extremely well, so did LDLC. I'm just happy that we had such an entertaining game in the end. You know, third map, really, really insane job by both teams.
Yeah. You don't look old enough to use some of that language you were using.
He was really off color, if you will.
He was sailor talking.
Very sailorish. And again, amazing stuff. And Sean, who's going to join us for the finals, was kind of standing next to us too.
Yeah.
And I was like, look familiar, a little deja vu here. 16-14, obviously, yeah. Neck and neck, down to the wire. 28th round was kind of that one of those turning point rounds that turned it right back towards LDLC, but just not enough.
That was just so close. I mean, all those key rounds, like Happy won a crucial one-on-one against Get Right, then 14-14 to give NIP the edge on the last map, you know. So many small plays that turned out to be so important. That last map was one of the most intense maps of the whole tournament so far.
Yeah, I mean, I gotta say, LDLC are gonna be devastated, right? I mean, that's the crazy thing about it, and yet no one, you know, well, almost no one, predicted that they were gonna do as well as they did and come so close to making the final of a major. I hope they're not too disappointed. But when they do analyze this demo, they're going to look back at two absolute key rounds where Freiburg made two clutches when they had the bomb down or in a position to plant it, and they peaked, and there was no need to peak. And I don't get why they challenged. You said it was the rush of blood to the head.
Well, it was both that, and it can be good when basically you have the edge when you know where someone is, and you're going to have the advantage when you're going to peak because it is CSGO, and that's how it works in this game. So Freiburg was just waiting, and he had like 100 HP, and Happy, or I don't know who was in the clutch in a one-on-one, but had 30 HP or something, and Happy dropped Freiburg very low, like one hit is death. And he just re-picked on the last time, and Freiburg got the best out of him. You know, that was that close, it was that close. So in the end, LDLC players played great, even on those after-plant situations, even though obviously it's a new map, so you make mistakes because you don't know the placement, etc. But I think we saw on that map why those 10 players are here. We know why they deserve to be at such a high level of play, because all of them, they delivered something that was special to the game.
The elephant in the room, of course, and I really didn't want to do this, but the elephant in the room is Fifth Laren. I thought had a really poor performance. Now, analysts and commentators and pundits, whatever you want to call us, I think we have a really hard time saying anything bad about Fifth Lauren, because honestly, the criticism and the hate he gets is it's a disgusting level. If you ever want an example of a model professional of how to handle being in the spotlight, Fifth Lauren does it with real style and real class. But I got to say, he went like 4-18 or maybe 4-19, I think it was. And that's just not good enough. I mean, it really felt in this on this map especially that his teammates kind of carried him a bit.
Yeah, well, I don't know. Lately, Fifth Lauren has been in kind of a downside. But the thing is, the hate on Fifth Lauren will never stop, even though he's going to perform well, which is what he did for the last 4 or 5 months.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
He played extremely well.
Exactly.
But like, just at this tournament, he couldn't pick it up. But no matter what, I'm 100% sure that Fifth Lauren is a key player in NIP within the team, because he's going to put everyone together. He's going to be the one motivating the troops or even helping tactically. So.
And you can see, sorry, it was 5-19 in the end there. Yeah. And that's what I'm talking about, that disparity. I mean, look, again, don't want to throw Robin under the bus. So right. Hopefully he'll forgive me for this when I see him again. But I mean, I feel like, you know, you're going into the final of a major and you come off the back of a performance like that. I mean, I don't know. Have you ever been in that position where you've been bottom of the frag charts by such a long distance and you've got a final to look forward to?
Well, yeah. And when it happens, the only thing you can do is being thankful for your teammate first to, like, pick it up, because you cannot be at the top of the scoreboard every single time. And he had a bad game. He had a bad day probably. But the next best of three is going to be a complete different game. And he can just come back and, like, top of the charts. Like,
I hope he does.
I mean, I really hope for him and, like, to shut everyone up pretty much, you know, like, on farms and everywhere, because that's not something he deserves. He's definitely a key player, and he's having a bad day, all right. But, you know, we should look at Freiburg, Get Right, Exist, Apex, Cardi. They all had extremely good performances.
I got to say thank you to Freiburg, because I tipped him as a guy to watch, and then he went 1-8. And I was like, oh, my God, like, don't let this happen to me again. I can't take it. But he really stepped it up and made some picks. But just, again, to talk about LDLC, because I don't want to focus on NIP. We'll talk about them before the final. Just huge individual performances. Apex, again, yes. Top of the frag charts. Kaylee, you know, just behind him, made some absolute beast orb shots. I mean,
incredible.
Those guys, they've proven they're elite players.
Definitely. And just the last thing I wanted to point out on the statistics, the weapon that Get Right used the most was a P90.
Again.
Which is only the fact on cobblestone, so he probably discovered something with the P90, you know, like something with, like, an Alchemy with the bat.
Sean explained it to me when we did the previous cast, and he said it's because when you drop down into that kind of area where they're rushing through, you know they're going to be grouped up in a close proximity.
Exactly.
You need 50 bullets, because then you can get a four-man or, a you know, an ace or
100%.
Whatever.
So, yeah, that shows how NIP are adapting to every single situation and how they can adapt to new maps. But obviously, LDLC did an excellent job as well. I mean, it's props to both teams. LDLC have been extremely good on the first map, NIP on the second map. In the third map, the level was the same. They ended up 16-14. It could have gone either way. That was pretty much the point of the game. It was anyone's game, pretty much. And it was down to those 3-on-3s, those two clutches from Freiburg, and, you know, it just came down to that. That's Counter-Strike. That's the beauty of Counter-Strike.
And NIP's ability to win ECOs and force buys.
Yes.
Which they did on 3 or 4 occasions.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
And that completely skewed the game back in their favor. I mean, Sean was laughing about it. He wasn't laughing quite so much yesterday, but he was laughing about it watching it with us, saying, you know, they always win those rounds. Like, just when you think that's it, it's finally over for them. And they powered the way to a final based on that.
Yeah, that's NIP introduced this kind of buys in the game at the beginning. They surprised everyone by buying like between 2 and 3K, like max 7s or like just pistols, just surprising people. And that worked out extremely well. And they know how to play those rounds. And that worked out extremely well once again, especially on cobblestone, a map where you don't really know the angles and you're going to surprise people very easily. And big props to NIP for that.
Yeah, agreed. That being said, we're going to go to Paul at the desk. But again, thank you again, Nathan, for joining us. Pleasure to hear your insight into the game. I'm sorry that your fellow countryman and your Swiss friend, we must give Maniac credit. He's not a Frenchman.
Disappointed.
Yeah. But again, they've solidified themselves. They're currently ranked 5, so they've actually upped themselves a little bit. In, you know, and obviously those rankings change constantly. But again, like you said, not going to be happy with that. That was kind of in the bag, went both ways.
So close. So,
that being said, we're going to go to Red Eye. He's at the stage. Take it away, Paul.
Thank you very much, Scott, with Fifth Lauren right now after a terrific match. Fantastic game by both teams. Very, very close all the way through. in ordinary circumstances, I'd be standing here saying congratulations on reaching a second consecutive major final, but that's just not good enough for Ninjas in Pyjamas. They've got to win this thing, right?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, this was just the semifinals. We're going to face a very strong Fnatic in the finals. You know, it's not a roll in the park.
All right, talk us through the game. Game one, match one, map one. What are you guys thinking when you go in? Are you nervous still? I mean, you guys have been doing this so long, you don't get nervous, right?
No, we weren't nervous. I mean, we just know that we're always bad on the first map. Always. Like, it's a given. Even the last major we had, we were bad on the first map on almost every single game in the best of three. And then I think when they had 15 rounds, that's when we start to wake up. And we start picking up rounds, but, you know, it's a little bit too late. Then obviously, switching to Nuke, Nuke was our pick, you know, and we feel that we are very strong on Nuke, even though the score yesterday didn't really justify that. We just kept on rolling. We got a really good T half, and then, you know, we just closed it out on the CT side.
Yeah, I mean, look back a year ago. I remember having a chat with you on a stage, and we were talking about how bad you guys were at pistols, and you just had this kind of mind block. You couldn't win a pistol round to save your lives, and it seems now you can't win a first map to save your. Why do you guys go through these sort of these emotions when you get into specific things? You get like a mental block, or what is it?
I'm not sure. I mean, I think it's gone to the point now where, you know, it doesn't matter how much deathmatch or whatever you do before the game. It's just you need to have that, you know, game mentality. And that's something that we currently don't have in the first map, which is a shame. And then obviously we're still bad on pistols as well. So add that onto the fact that we lost the first map and then we were bad on pistols. Then, you know, I think that we're just making it harder for ourselves.
Yeah, definitely doing that. You yourself... I almost don't want to talk about Cobble because it's a bad game for you, but it's a tough map for both teams, right?
Yeah, Cobble is extremely hard, and yeah, as probably all of you saw, and I probably have 100 HLTV threats now saying negative fifth floor and didn't get any frags, and I can assure you guys, Cobble is an extremely hard map to play. It's super hard, and since it's a new map as well, you don't really know what works and what doesn't work. So you're just guessing most of the time. So you're just like, okay, well, this might work, or, you know, this setup might work, and you're basically gambling most of the times. And then add that on top of the fact that we're playing against five very strong individual players, and then, you know, I'm old and I suck. So add that onto that, and you're not going to get a lot of frags. But I'm super happy that the rest of my teammates, they played superb. I don't have any words for it. They played super well, and it's because of them that we won.
Okay, well, that's very, very humble of you to say so. I think it's much more than that. It's a team game, obviously. But let's look forward. Let's look to the final. You guys, effectively, we've had, you know, I don't want to undermine LDLC, but you've just had a terrific warm-up for the final because you're fresh, you're ready to go. But on the flip side of that, you guys put everything in to win that. So how are you guys feeling right now? Are you ready for the final? Are you feeling a little bit jaded, a little bit underpowered? What's going on?
Yeah, I mean, obviously that game took a lot out on us, so we need to get some food, we need to get some energy back up, because, you know, Fnatic isn't a walk in the park. They're an extremely good team, that, you know, and they play very good against us. They're one of those teams that we have a very hard time against, so we really need to be 100%, and, you know, that means that we need to get some energy, we need to, you know, drink a lot of water and just be mentally and physically prepared for the game.
Well, best of luck. Thank you very much, Fifth Laren, everyone, from Ninjas in Pyjamas, who have managed to go through to their second consecutive major final for Counter-Strike Global Offensive. That grand final is coming up very shortly. Go and tell your friends, your mum, your dad, your nan, your granddad, your aunts, your uncles, your cousins, your second cousins, people on the street, get them in here right now and join us to set some new records for Counter-Strike Global Offensive. We'll see you after the break.